Hello friends! This video is on how to loom knit a beautifully textured purl and rib stitch hat. I've made this hat on a 46 peg extra large gauge loom, as well as on a 48 peg large gauge loom. This hat is for you if you already know how to do the e-wrap knit stitch and the purl stitch. There are lots of purl stitches in this pattern, so if you don't like purling, this project is not for you. My name's Catherine, and I'd like to thank you for watching my first hat tutorial on Ms. Yarn. If you haven't subscribed yet, please click subscribe, since that shows YouTube that my videos are worth watching, and this in turn helps me reach a greater audience. In this video, I'm using a 46 peg Martha Stewart loom, but you can still follow this video with a different round loom. We're going to cover number 1, how to mark your loom. Number 2, how to cast on using an e-wrap and purl cast on. Number 3, how to do the rib stitch brim. Number 4, how to do the purl and rib stitch body. And number 5, how to do a crown decrease. And lastly, number 6, how to do the gather bind off. For the supplies you're going to need, a round loom like this 46 peg loom with a 3/4 inch gauge. And as I mentioned earlier, you can also use a 48 peg loom with a 5/8 inch gauge, just like the CinDWood loom. You'll also need one ball of yarn like this Wool Ease Thick and Quick number 6 yarn. You'll need a hook, a pair of scissors, a yarn needle, and some stitch markers. Okay, let's get started. Let's begin by marking our loom. You'll need to mark peg 1. I've marked peg 1 with some blue elastic. And since we're going to be doing the rib stitch quite a bit, you might want to mark either when you knit or when you purl. On my loom, I've got pink pegs to show where I need to purl. Also, we're going to be doing a crown decrease over 4 pegs. So I found it really helpful to separate my loom into sets of 4. That's why you can see some green tape here. You might notice that I have a pair of pegs at the very end. They're pegs 45 and 46, and that's fine. That's just because 46 doesn't divide evenly into 4. Okay, so now that we've marked our loom, let's cast on. So to cast on, we're going to use what I'm calling the e-wrap and purl cast on. So first, let's start by tying a loose knot onto our loom. I don't have an anchor peg, so I'll tie a knot between peg 46 and peg 1. Then I'm going to e-wrap on peg 1, which means I go back to front, counterclockwise. And I'm going to do e-wraps like this all the way around the loom. You could e-wrap on your own, and you can meet me in a few minutes when you're back at peg 1. So I've gone ahead on my own, and I'm just finishing up this first round of e-wraps. I've wrapped peg 46, and what I'm going to do is e-wrap on peg 1. I'll knit over that bottom loop. I'll purl on peg 2. I'll e-wrap on peg 3. And I'll purl on peg 4. So for the cast on, we're going to keep alternating these e-wrap knits and purl stitches. So cast on like this on your own, and let's meet soon when you've gone all the way around the loom. So I've gone ahead, and now I'm finishing up with the last 4 pegs of this cast on. Okay, excellent. So now our cast on is done. Let's do a rib stitch brim over 8 rounds. So let's do an E-wrap knit stitch on peg 1 and a purl stitch on peg 2. We'll E-wrap on peg 3 and then purl on peg 4. So let's do 8 rounds in total. What you can do is finish the rib stitch brim on your own. And let's meet again when you're finished with round 8. At this point, we've completed 8 rounds of the rib stitch brim. Now, the purl and rib stitch body is made up of a 3-row repeat. So for round 9, we're going to do purl stitches for the entire round. So let's purl on peg 1. We'll purl on peg 2. And then purl on peg 3. So you're going to keep up with this purling all the way around the loom. Let's meet in a few minutes when you've finished this round. See you soon. So I've gone ahead, I'm still on round 9, and I'm just finishing up the last few pegs of this purl round. So I'm purling on peg 46. And now round 9 is done. And that's the first row of this 3-row repeat. For the second and third rows of the repeat, you'll do a knit 1, purl 1 sequence. So for round 10, let's knit on peg 1 and purl on peg 2. We'll knit on peg 3 and purl on peg 4. Keep knitting and purling, and when you get to round 11, you'll also knit 1, purl 1. After that, round 12 is just like round 9. It's a purl row. And rounds 13 and 14 are just like rounds 10 and 11. I ended up doing 9 sets of this 3-row repeat, and then I finished off with a purl round, which was round 36. And at that point, my hat measured 8.5 inches from the cast on. Now, if you want your hat to be shorter than mine, you can finish after another purl round, like round 33 or even round 30. Now, also keep in mind that the crown decrease will add about 2 inches to the top of your hat. So my hat ended up being about 10 and a half inches in height, and that's what I was looking for. At this point, let's knit on our own for a couple of hours, and we'll meet again when you finished your last round of purl stitches. Then we're going to decrease the stitches together. So we've made great progress on this hat. We've completed round 36 to finish off the purl and rib stitch body. Now we're going to reduce the top of the hat. We'll be working over 4 pegs, so I'll be referring to pegs 1, 2, 3, and 4 over and over again, no matter where we are on the loom. And the green tape is helping me keep track of these sets of 4 pegs. So let's start the decrease by knitting on peg 1. We purl on peg 2. We move the stitch on peg 4 over to peg 3. Then we'll knit on peg 3. So let's knit over both of those bottom loops, and we can do it one at a time if that's easier. Okay, let's go to the next set. Knit on peg 1. Purl on peg 2. move 4 to 3. Knit on peg 3. Now let's knit over both of those bottom loops. All right, let's go to the next set. And again, knit on peg 1. Purl on peg 2. Move 4 to 3. And then knit on peg 3. So what we're doing to peg 3 is, in a pattern, I think it would be called an SSK, by the way. I also wanted to mention that the objective here is to go from 46 stitches to 35 stitches. Let's decrease on our own, and we'll meet later when we're finished this round, which is round 37. So I'm still finishing up on round 37. I'm doing my last decrease. So the last two pegs, even though they don't belong in a set of four, they don't get any special treatment. I'll knit on peg 1, purl on peg 2, and now round 37 is done. And now for round 38, we're going to do another round, and we're going to stay in pattern again, which means that we're going to knit on the pegs where we usually knit for the rib stitch, and we'll purl on the pegs where we usually purl for the knit for the rib stitch. So we knit on 1, purl on 2, and knit on 3. Now we do the same thing again. We knit on 1, purl on 2, and knit on 3. So you'll work your way around the loom, and let's meet later when you've gone all the way around. So I'm just finishing up round 38. So I knit on 1, purl on 2, knit on 3. For the next set, we just have two pegs. I'll knit on 1, purl on 2. Now round 38 is done. And now it's time for our second decrease. Now we're on our second crown decrease, and we want to go from 35 stitches down to 23 stitches. Let's start by moving the stitch from peg 2 to peg 1. Then we'll knit on peg 1. Then we knit on peg 3. Let's go to the next set, and we'll move 2 to 1. We'll knit on 1. Then we knit on 3. Again, let's move 2 to 1. We'll knit on 1 and knit on 3. At the end of this round, which is round 39, you'll have a stitch on every other peg. So now at this point, you can decrease on your own, and let's meet again when you've done this round. So I've gone ahead and I'm just finishing up with round 39. So I move 2 to 1. I knit on 1. I knit on 3. Now for this last set, it's just 2 of them. I move 2 to 1. And then I knit on 1. Okay, great. So now round 39 is done. So round 40 is super easy. It's the very last round of this hat, and you're just going to e-wrap on all of the pegs that have stitches on them. So that means that you're going to be doing an e-wrap knit stitch on every other peg. So do this on your own, and let's meet when you're done. So I've completed round 40 and we're ready to bind off. Let's have a look first though at the right side of the hat. So we can see the really nice textured body there. For the gather bind off, we need to cut off a long piece of yarn. Wrap your yarn around the loom. And I'm cutting my yarn after wrapping it 1 1/4 times. Even if you wrap your loom just once, that will be fine as well. So I've cut the yarn, and now I'd like to bring the yarn up each peg. So I can either use my hook or a yarn needle. First, I'm going to demonstrate with the hook. I lay the yarn below the loop. I dive in with my hook to scoop it up, and I'll pull the yarn upwards. Okay, so I've done peg 1. Now I'll go behind peg 2. And let's bring the yarn up the loop on peg 3. Let's pop the loop off peg 3 and go behind peg 4. Let's use our hook to bring the yarn up the loop on peg 5. Now take the loop off peg 5 and go behind peg 6. For peg 7, I'll show you how I'm using a yarn needle to bring the yarn up the loop. Take the loop off peg 7 and continue the gather bind off on your own. Let's meet when you've gone all the way around. So here I've worked my way around the loom and I'm binding off on pegs 43 and 45. Now let's take the loop off peg 1 and our hat is completely off the loom. I'm just going to turn my hat right side out. Then I'll gently pull the yarn to close the hole. So it's not gathering as smoothly as I want, but I just need to be patient and gentle by working my yarn through those last stitches, even if I have to go stitch by stitch. So now I've closed the hole, but I've had to pull the yarn in separate sections because it was getting caught. But now it's closed. So the crown is looking very nice. The hole is almost completely closed and I haven't even pulled the yarn really tight. Before I thread my yarn needle with the tail, I'm going to cut off some of the excess length. The tail is quite long, and then I'm threading the needle. I'll poke the needle inside the hat so that I can work on the wrong side of the hat. Now my hat's inside out. I'm tugging on the yarn a bit, and I'll weave around the hole in a clockwise direction. Then I'll weave down one of these columns and go down several stitches, and then I'll cut off the end on my own. Now I've skipped ahead to weave in the tail at the cast on, and I'll thread my yarn needle. I'll weave up one of these columns and I'll do several stitches, and once I'm comfortable, I'm just going to cut off the excess yarn. I've woven in both of my ends now, so let's see the hat when it's right side out. Okay, it looks great. So we can see this lovely texture. We can see the crown, which looks really nice. It's not too bulky at the top. It's stretchy, and I think it looks really wonderful. So if you did like this video, please subscribe, leave a comment, press like. I'd really appreciate it.